Hi, in previous lessons, we have created a single creation Python part. In this lesson 9, we will finalize our Python part by adding a column to the center of our single creation. Firstly, we need another interface page for column. Copy paste creation page and rename it as column page. Run again and we have another page for the column that's very similar to the foundation page. The script to create a column is also similar to create a foundation. Run again and change the size to see the column. Let's change the default value for the column size. We created a column, but it's now in the bottom left location. We need to move it to the center of the creation. To move a polyhedron 2D, we can use the function move from geometry module. Near the bottom of the geometry module, we have a move function. You can move different objects here, but we need to move polyhedron 2D. Here we have two arguments. The first one is the polyhedron that we need to move, and the second is a vector 3D. The return type is polyhedron 3D after moving. Check vector 3D class, and we see that it needs XYZ flows arguments. Let's create a method to move column to the center of the foundation. This method will take two arguments, build underscore error and the column geometry. Firstly, we need to create a vector from the bottom left to the center. X will be half of the foundation length minus half of the column. Similar for Y. Z is the foundation height. Then we can move the column using this vector. And return the column after moving. We will call this method before creating model element 2D. Run again to see the result. To add a picture to our PythonPart, we need BNG file that has same name with the PythonPart. Copy it to BYP location. Now we're done. Finish. After installing Visual Studio Code, go to Run and Debug. Write a launch JSON file and copy this setting to launch file. You can find this setting in etc PythonPart framework PythonPart.doc. Note that you may need to change this symbol. Save it and go to ALLPLAN. In Examples, Tools and Start Examples, run Start Python Debug and write OK. Go to Visual Studio Code and run a check on ALLPLAN. Now you can debug by adding breakpoint in your script. Run your PythonPart and it will stop at the breakpoint. Please connect to exit. If you are a beginner, just start with ALLPLAN PythonPart. I recommend to find class and method using PythonPart's website. After you are familiar with that, we can use autocomplete in Visual Studio Code. Example, if I call the module like this and press, I want to see all the classes and functions in this module. To do that, first we need to install PyLens. Then go to Settings and find Extra Path. In Analysis, Extra Path, rest add item. Go to etc PythonPart framework interface stuff. Copy this path into extra path and press OK. You can see this setting in settings.json file. Restart Visual Studio Code. Now, whenever I call the module, Visual Studio Code will list all the classes and functions. I recommend to write type hint for your script. Example, for this graphization method, it checks a build underscore error and returns a list of model element 3D. Instead of just write string like this, we could write type hint. Build underscore error is a building element class. This building element class, you must import from building element. And this building element is located in general scripts folder. Copy this path and add to extra path. Remember to reply a backslash by two backslashes. After you write a hint, Visual Studio Code can recognize what a build underscore error argument and so suggestion methods properties of that type. This method returns a list of model element 2D. We must import this list keyword from typing. Similarly, you can write a hint for all methods. Thank you for watching my video tutorial. I highly encourage you to subscribe our channel for more videos.